Zach, how about this one then?
150.
150. Yes? This one.
I got 160.
Sorry, I can't hear because a lot of people are talking. How many people should be talking?
One.
One. Go ahead.
I got 160.
Why is there still talking?
No, I didn't. I just started talking.
All right. 160. Dalton?
I got 2,000 for that one.
2,000 for that one. All right? We agree?
Yeah.
We all agree. 2,000 what?
2,000 squares.
Squares. Or units squared. Good. We're doing well at figuring out the difference between squares and squared and why squared is in our heads and you know what it really means and how it relates to squares. Questions?
What's the base for the 150 one?
Should be four right there. Same as this one. You can see how they kind of 2,000, 150, 160, 12. Okay? Say we add these all up. 2,000, 160, 150, and 12. Did anybody happen to do that?
No. Oh, it's 2,
2,322. Okay. So making sure we agree. 2,322 squares. Okay. So that's from 3 times 4 is 12. 3 times 50 is 150. 4 times 40 is 160. 50 times 40 is 2,000 squares. Alright. At the very end of class last time, I had this up. I don't even know if you noticed it much because it was right at the very end. Okay? I want you to notice this one right there. Did you find the area of that one? Remembering?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know if you remembered right.
Yeah, you're wrong. Sorry.
Oh, I guess.
Yeah,
2,322.
No,
I got
2,322. 2,322 squares.
Yeah,
I got
2,212.
Oh, I got it right. You got it wrong, Katie. No, I see. Well, let's see.
Yeah.
It should be 43 times 54, right?
Yeah,
well,
that's what I
got.
Hey, those are the exact same
symbols.
Yeah, I think
you just noticed that. These multiplication problems and the area of each of these rectangles. I had the same number answer, right?
Not
this. This is just 43 times 52. 43 what? 52 what? Or 54? 54 what? 43 what? Nothing there. But here it's 43. What can we say there's 43 on?
Square things.
Squares?
Cubic inches.
No, like inches, like a linear measure. Inches or feet, right? Not squares. We get squares if we multiply it. And 54 what? Inches, 43 inches, 54 inches. Okay, that's different. This is not really nothing related to these, no units at all. We can imagine this to these. So let's multiply these two together as we're used to doing. All right, there's some steps involved here, right? 4 times 3.
12.
16, again, a 1 gets carried, 4 is 20, 21, right?
Yeah.
Okay, 2, 7, 5 is 12, 3, and 2, 7, 3, and 22.
That's not bad, after I figured out what it was.
How did you what?
You went through.
That should be the first time you're seeing that, right? You've seen that before.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that one on all that.
Yes, okay. Oh, okay. No, not accident, I mean, you just, either way, it's the same, isn't it? Well, the answer should be the same, 54 times 30, 54 times 43, or 43 times 54, it should be the exact same thing.
That's what you missed.
Not right now, no. Maybe if we have some time at the end, we'll see. Okay, so the thing that I want you to see is, we can multiply these two numbers together, and we can get the right answer, really not have any idea why we do what we do, why we carry, what's this number times this number mean, okay? I want you to see, you can do 43 times 54, you can represent that as an area, right? Follow along, put your books away, please, it's not reading time. Thank you. We can take that rectangle and split it into four rectangles, like this. Where I, and I cut it out, I can actually, I can assemble these back into one big rectangle. So how long is this side of the rectangle?
53.
54.
4, yeah, if you remember that 4 there. And how long is this side?
43.
Right, so the area of this big rectangle should be whatever 54 times 43 is. When we split it into smaller multiplication problems, 2,322.
You just did that, yeah.
But you can see what the algorithm is doing, 54 times 43, where you do the 4 times the 3, and the 4 times the 5, and so on and so on. When we do this first part, 4 times 3, we're really finding how many 4 times 3 is, right? 4 is a 1 and 3 is a 1, right? 4 ones and 3 ones. So when we multiply one by one, what do we get?
One.
Ones. We're counting up the ones, we have 12 ones. When you do 3 times 4 and you get 12, you're saying you have 12 ones. I'm just gonna copy this back to you. Here's going back and forth.
That's cool.
When you do 4 times 3, we're saying 12 ones. It's like, when you say 12, you really mean 12 ones, right? But here's the thing about 4 times 4, the next step. Is it really 4 times 4?
Yeah,
12 times.
4
ones.
Look, I've done some terrible things. Why do you always look when you're hovering your mouse?
So, 4 times 3 tells us 12, but 4 times 4, is it 4 times 4? That was the question. Is it 4 times 4 really?
Yeah.
4 times 4 ones.
4 times 4 ones?
Yeah.
Others?
4 squares times 4.
Well, I don't think so, because like you still have to do like carry 40.
Mm-hmm. So not just 4 times 4, not like 4 times 3 was just 4 times 3. It's 4 times... is it 4 ones?
4 tens.
4 tens. You can see that, where do we see that? We got 4 times 4 tens, so 4, 4, and 4 tens, right? So the area of this is counting up all of those squares. When I say 4 times 4 and I get 16, is it really 16? Right, which is 16 of what?
Ten.
Tens, right? A 1 times a 10 is a what?
Ten.
20. 1 times a 10 is a 10. So when I do 4 times 4, I'm really doing 4 times 40. I'm finding how many tens I have. Okay? And in this case, we get so many tens that we get some what?
Hundreds.
Hundreds. We get over to the hundreds because we had so many tens that we just found. 4 times 40 is how many tens we have. Well, 4 times 40 is how many ones we have, but 4 times 4 tens is going to find how many tens we have. 16 tens. Okay? So we're starting to see the secret behind all of this stuff. Yeah.
How did you learn how to break it down like that?
How did I learn this? I've seen it a lot in the last couple of years, with Common Core being the thing now, right? And one big focus that they're trying to put in math classes is, why do all these things work? And we talked about it at the beginning of the year, where there are apps that I can download on my phone, scan 43 times 54, and it just gives me the answer.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
I don't even need a calculator. I just need a camera on my phone, scans it, tells me the answer. So with computers being able to do more and more and more and more on their own,
they're
less and less and less important. Okay, so we need to understand why and not just the how. Tiana?
So what's with the app and phone thing? So when I first got my MacBook, my dad was messing around with his phone, and he went and asked my stepmom for a MacBook. Because they're both in college.
Uh-huh.
She doesn't have one. And so he asked for mine. And he went through and just found a random page and then solved one of the algebra problems by an app that he got. So
The same app I'm referring to does that too. It'll solve simple algebra problems.
I had that
app. Yeah. No, it was quite a complex algebra problem.
It'll solve linear equations, meaning there's no like x squares or y squares.
No, there wasn't x squares. But x.
Called a math papa.
4.
It's
called a math papa.
Okay, a math papa. All we're doing is establishing that your ability to know how to do things is less and less important. Okay? In the 60s, it was really important that people know how to do things and be able to crunch those numbers really fast, so we could get a spaceship to the moon. Right? But now, computers can do that stuff so much faster than we can, so much more accurately, where it puts us in the position of, I think in the nice position of being able to spend more time talking about why these things work and not just like learning all these algorithms and having to memorize how to do them and not understanding. So, now we could have broken this up into any four squares we wanted to. We could have just split them right down the middle. It still would give us the right answer. It'd give us four rectangles. When we add up all the areas of all four rectangles, we get the total area of the big rectangle. Okay? But where did we break it? Right at the sides. Why? There's like 50 here and 4 there. Where's that dividing line? Like, what? How did I make that choice of where to break it? What do I have here? What do I have here? Right, tens and ones. Okay. That's what this algorithm does. It just breaks it into different place values. Tens, ones, if you have hundreds, break it into the hundreds. Right? If I had 132, I would do 100, and then 30, and then 2. And finding the area of that rectangle would be the exact same thing you're doing here, okay? But it's just much more obvious. That's what I've done. I'm just taking 40s. 4 tens times 4 ones and finding 16 tens, or 160 squares. Here, we have, how long is this side?
1. 3.
Ones, right? 3 ones.
1.
Okay. 3 ones times what? 5 what? 5 tens.
Of tens.
Right? So we're going to find again, how many tens do we have? finding tens here and finding tens here. That's where we get this, but they line up right here. How many tens? Now, there's not any carrying here. We don't carry. We just count all the squares and we add up all the squares. Okay. We could do that here too. Let me just erase all of this with the carrying. Of course, we carry because it's faster. It's simpler. It's cleaner. It takes up less room. And those things are nice. But we also sometimes can forget about why the carrying is happening. So if I do 3 times 4 and get 12, I can just write 12 down there. Right? Just count up all the ones. So many ones, I got some tens as well. And then 4 times 4, it's really 4 times 40. 4 times 40 is 160. Okay? Now we're done. We don't multiply the 4 by all that stuff. Now we move over to this 5, which isn't really 5, it's what?
5 tens.
50. 5 tens, yeah, 50 or 5 tens. 50 times 30. 5 tens times 3 ones is 15 80. Tens, 150.
Yeah.
15 tens or 180. And then 5 times 4, which isn't really 5 times 4, it's
20.
50 times 40.
Oh, it's 2,000.
We found 5 times 4 is 20. Okay, when we do 5 times 4 is 20 in that algorithm that we typically do, we find 20. 20 what? 20. 100s, 20 hundreds, because tens times tens are hundreds, right? There's 10 things in here, right? Or 20, sorry. 5 times 4, I could mark it off into 10 squares, but each of those squares would be 100 squares, like 101 squares. Yeah?
So in what situation would you, instead of just like solving 43 times 54, in what situation would you, like, I guess the question is, if you were finding
no, if I saw 4 rectangles and I noticed they could be assembled into one big mega rectangle, I would just do 54 times 43. I'm doing 54 times 43, I'm doing all those steps, I'm doing all of these things separately. You see what I'm saying? I'm trying to reveal how, when you say, oh, just do 43 times 54, 43 times 54, you're doing all 4 of these things. You don't realize it. You're finding how many ones, okay, we found all the ones, and if I have so many ones that I get tens as well, like so many ones that it makes some tens, that's the carry. Right? I bring it over to where the tens reside and add that into the next calculation, which is how many tens do I have when I do 4 times 4 tens. And you can see all that carried out here without the carrying, without the adding of along the way. You see what we do? We find 12 ones, 16 tens, 15 tens, 20 hundreds, and we add it all together. And that's what we did right here. So those steps that you're doing now have some reason behind them, have some sense behind them. Now, if you already thought, every time that you multiply these things together, you thought 3 times 4, oh, that's 2 ones, and I got a 10, so I'm going to bring it over to the tens place. That's good, because you're remembering about place value, and place values are important. But if you're just carrying ones, carrying fives and threes, and really not knowing what's going on, and thinking that this is 4 times 4, when it's really not, it's 4 times 4. Is a lot bigger than 4 times 4. When you get 16, it's not 16, it's 16 tens, okay? And it's nice to be able to see very clearly why you do everything you do here. And in addition to seeing that, this little rectangular area represents multiplication model. We get to a couple of really nice tools. What we're going to use today, we're going to see why we multiply fractions the way we multiply fractions. Then, later, not today, maybe in the next couple of 3 weeks, you're going to see the distributive property. Have you guys done distributive property before?
Yeah, I've heard of it.
But this multiplication here can show us why do we have to distribute, okay? We'll talk about that at another time. Today we're going to see why it can prove fraction multiplication works the way that it does. Well, the reason why I had a little play on it is if I press this now, you can see how many squares fit inside. So there I go. to find the area of all four of these, what multiplication problem would I be doing here? What's that?
29 times 35.
Yeah. And when I do 29 times 35, when I set it up, and I do 5 times 9, and I do 5 times 2, and 3 times 9, and 3 times 2, I'm doing all four of these things. Okay? Make sense?
I like the carrying in the bag.
See, that's, you're losing focus on what we're doing here. I'm not trying to show you the new way you're going to multiply things together, right? Showing you something that explains
how it works.
What it all is doing, what's happening, what is carrying, what's going on, what do all those things represent. If it's possible to do all that, have no idea what you're really doing, which seems kind of magical. Okay. You can do that here too, but it's a little harder because you're having to think about figuring the thing, what's going on, and multiply these numbers together and find the number of squares. Okay. Number one squares, I can count up 10 squares here. Groups of 10 squares, groups of 10 squares here, group of 100 squares. All right, enough of that. So we're going to talk about, we're going to use that area model of multiplication. And we're going to take that idea of finding the area of a rectangle and seeing it as a representation of multiplication and use it to show us why fraction multiplication works the way that it does. Okay? Before we do that, let's just see if you can remember how to multiply two fractions together. So we'll multiply 9 sixteenths by 7/2. Okay. Multiply those two fractions together, see if you can remember how to do that. Pencil, pens. A fraction is, you first have to understand what a fraction is. What is it telling you? Please put your binder down, if you would. Okay. 6/11. Let's talk about this bottom number. What's the name of this bottom number? Has a name?
Denominator.
The denominator, very good. The denominator is telling you something. I want you to think about this fraction as a number, not the, like a division problem, 6 divided by 11. Which it is 6 divided by 11. But think of it as a number, 6/11. It's 6 of something. Let's talk about 11. What does it mean, this denominator, this number 11? What is it saying? What is 11 about it? We don't have to worry about 6. You were on a good path there. If you had 11,
then you have 11. Until you use your denominator.
I have 11 things. Sounds like you're saying if you have 11, you put them all together, then what do you have?
One.
We have one. Right? If we have 11 of these things, we have one thing. So, you're looking at me like,
what?
Speaking Greek or something.
What is that?
Any mathematician talking about 11 and things and have and if, those are all English words. If you had 11 things, these things, all together, what you would have is one. So I could have one apple, right? I could cut that apple into 11 pieces. That's what this is talking about. I've cut the thing, the apple, the line, the rectangle, the pizza, whatever, into 11 pieces, all right? So this would be, let's put it this way, size of the pieces. I'm confused with what I mean by that. 11 is the size of the pieces. Yes?
I'm kind of confused because if you said by the size of the pieces, I don't know, I think like, oh, 11 inches is the size of a piece. Like that's what I'm thinking. Like, what do you mean by size of two pieces? I thought you just had 11 of one thing.
This is, you have 11 parts of one bigger whole.
Okay.
So another way to say it is I have 11. You can say that's how many pieces make one whole. And that whole could be anything. A whole pizza, a whole cake, a whole candy bar, they're all food, I don't know why. A whole paycheck,
a whole
savings account.
Pencil.
Pencil, why not? Not sure why you cut a pencil into 11 pieces, but you certainly could do it. Okay? That one would be a little easier because it's big if you cut it into 11 pieces. Does that clarify it? Okay, so it's just how many things you have in one whole. And that's why I say just size, because it's kind of short, and it also kind of conveys this, right? Size of the pieces. There's, it implies that you've cut something into pieces. All right. So whether we say size of the pieces or how many pieces make one whole, that's what the denominator is saying. On the same page? So far, so good? Thumbs up? Then if this is saying how many make a whole, then what is 6 saying?
How many of the pieces that you've taken from the whole? Like, let's say you cut a pencil into 6, a pencil into 11 pieces,
okay.
And you only use 6 of them.
And you use 6.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And those 6 are gone.
So, let's say how many
of the things
you
took
have or use. Right, so far so good?
Yeah.
6 of the 11 things. 5/7, 5 of the 7 things, those 7 things, put them together, make one whole thing. Okay, so with this line, we're going to cut this line up in such a way that it shows us 6 elevenths. Can someone come up and show us 6 elevenths using this line?
What?
Can you come up and use this line and this pen and show us 6 elevenths?
Rather not.
Okay.
It's
gonna
be really unequal.
That's okay.
Okay,
that's hard to avoid. Showed us the 11. Let's make sure that he has. Like, did he count it off right?
Yeah, there's 11.
Double checking it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Indeed. Okay, so we see, what part of the 6 elevenths do we see right now?
The 11.
Okay, now show us the rest. Now what do we see?
6
elevenths. Okay, how do we know it's 6?
Because there's 5 left.
Okay, there's 5 left, and how do we know it's 11?
Because
11 is the beginning. 6 elevenths. There's 6 of something. What do I have 6 of? 11. 11ths. Okay. Thank you very much. Good job, Katie. 11ths. Those things that if you put them all together, 11 of them. You get one thing, a line in this case. Right? 1 foot, you divide a foot into 11 pieces. I don't know why you would, because it's usually into 12 pieces. There you go. Okay, we're building up slowly. If you're not paying attention now, the thing later is going to make less sense. So are we good so far?
Yeah.
The 11 means there's 11 in the whole. 6 means we have 6 of those things. And here's a picture of 6 elevenths.
Yep.
Okay. Now 4/5 and 3/8. I'm going to show you 4/5, and I'm going to show you 3/8. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Get that out of the way so we can see. I'm just going to cut it and put a piece in the middle. I'll try and put 2 pieces on either side. That's pretty close.
That's 4.
That's 5.
That's 5. There's 5 little pieces of it.
If those were like cuts, then how many pieces would I have? Now I'll show you 4/5 by going like that. Now let's look at 3/8. First I'll show you 8. I'll cut it in half. I'll cut that in half. Okay, so that's
4
pieces. So I'll cut each of those into 2 pieces. And we've got 8 pieces. I'm showing you the 8, the denominator is what I'm showing you right now. Now I'll show you the numerator. 3. Actually, it's a very special rectangle.
Right.
Called a
square.
It's
a square.
If it's a square, how long is this side?
5/4.
No, how long is from here to there?
5
what?
5
these.
5 lines.
Yeah.
5
we
spaces.
Don't know what it is.
Well, we do.
Five
faces. What? Yeah, we know they're fifths. Aubrey? You ready to continue?
Yeah, I'm ready.
So we have 5 what, Aubrey? Across the top, 5 what? Jason just said it. She's sitting right next to you. You're paying attention, so you heard her.
No, I wasn't paying attention.
Okay, let's pay attention. 5 what?
Fifths.
5/5. And what does 5/5 make?
A hole.
One hole. So this is 1. And how long is this side?
8/8.
A hole. One.
1 by 1.
It's 2.
Now if I make that into
magic.
If I make that into a rectangle, which is really a special rectangle called
a square.
It's 1 on this side and 1 on this side. We're using area. So if this is 1, and this is 1, you can call it inches or feet, whatever you want to call it. But what's the area of this square?
2. 1.
How many squares fit in this square?
Well, we don't know because each one.
What's that?
40.
1. 5. 1. 1.
2.
2.
2.
1. 2.
1.
4.
1.
2.
Look.
Oh, because it's just one big square.
Right. One big square. So, both sides are 1 in length, 1 inch, 1 foot, whatever. So the area of this 1 square is 1 square. Right? 1 square. Remember, fractions are pieces of the whole, so we're letting this represent 1 whole thing. Inside is 1 square. So,
but couldn't you, like,
well, let's look. Let's just say we take this little thing right there. Is that a square?
No, that's a rectangle.
Different sizes. This is a this way is a fifth. This is an eighth. It's not a square.
So the whole square is a rectangle.
All squares are rectangles. Here's what we're gonna do.
What?
I'm gonna cut the square this way into 5 pieces, and this way into 8 pieces. Listen to me. Stop quoting Brian Regan. Listen to me. Inside this rectangle, when we figure out exactly what we're looking at, we will see 3/8 times 4/5. The area of this little piece of the square is 4/5 times 3/8. Okay, all this stuff in here is 4/5 times 3/8. Now let's remember what a fraction is. The denominator is telling us how many pieces
there are total.
There are total.
And when you put them all together, you get what?
One whole.
One whole. Remember, one whole in this case is one big square.
Yeah.
Okay. And the numerator is telling us
how many
are in that.
Are taken?
How many are in that?
How many we have of those pieces?
Yeah. How many are in that?
Okay. First, let's figure out how many of these rectangles make up the whole thing.
Exactly.
35.
No, 40.
40.
Exactly.
How do we find 40 so quickly?
5 times 8.
5 this way. I cut this into 5 pieces this way and 8 pieces this way. So, all together, to make up one big square, it takes 40 of these things. These things aren't squares, but we do know that there's 40 of the exact same thing about these rectangles. Okay. So, 40 pieces make up the new whole thing. So that's why the denominator is 40. Now we need to figure out, the numerator, how many of those things we have. Well, here's one of them, and here's one of them, and here's one of them. How many do we have in this little rectangle?
12.
We have 12.
Yeah.
4 by 3. We have 12 of them. Now, if I were to go back and remember how to multiply fractions, do some simplification, but the most straightforward thing about multiplication of fractions is 8 times 5 is how
40.
Many pieces make up the whole? 3 times 4 is 12, how many pieces we have? Okay? No, you guys have been packing up mentally the whole time we've been here. Just listen up, okay? Last finishing thought here. When I learned fraction multiplication, I thought, how wonderful that we just multiply straight across. It's so much easier than adding fractions because we don't have common denominators, but I had no idea what in the world this all meant. Yeah, sometimes you get confused. You get cross multiplication. Not correct. Okay? You multiply straight across, and right there is why.
Okay, well, that's okay.
Okay? How many make the whole, and how many of those pieces do we have? That's what we now know. Good job today. Thank you.